Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to see the nested loop in Python. Okay, so how to use nested loop in Python? So this is one of the iteration control structure. So here placing one loop inside another loop is called as nested loop. So when you are placing a loop inside another loop, it is called a nested loop. We can put any type of loop structure inside any type of loop. For example, this is a syntax. So here you have an while, the condition inside I'm using one loop structure called while. So I'm going to place one loop structure inside one more loop structure. This is an inner loop and this is outer loop. So this is your nested loop. So here if you see while expression 1, while expression 2 statement. So every time you are going to use, you are going to write the statements inside while loop, you have to give indentation. So I'm giving one indentation, I'm writing this while loop. So that means this while loop comes under this particular outer loop. Now I'm going to give the statements inside the second while loop. So I have to give one indentation, I have to write the statement here. So statement 1, this statement 1 belongs to the inner loop, and statement 2 I'm not writing it inside, I'm writing it to the left of this. So this statement 2 belongs to the outer loop. Okay, this is the nested loop example. You will see one simple example where I'm using two for loops. You can use any type of loop structure. So in this example I've used two while loop. So here I'm using two for loop. For I in range of 1, 4, 1 colon, for j in range of 1, 4, 1, print I and j. Okay, this is the program. So in this case, the range of 1, 4, 1, the starting number is 1, ending number is till 4. That means it has to go by step 1 difference. So it is 1, 2, 3. This is range of 1, 4, 1 is 1, 2, 3, and this is also 1, 2, 3. Okay, so now we will see how this program will give you the output. So initially, since I will be equal to 1, 2, 3, I will have the value 1, right? I will be having the first time when it is executing, I will be having the value 1. It goes inside. So j value will be equal to, again j will be set to the first value. It goes inside, it will print I and j. So I will be 1 and j will be 1. Second time when it is goes, it proceed only with the inner loop. So I will be having the same value, but j will be incremented, j will be pointing to 2. So again it will print the values. What is I? I will be 1 and j will be 2. So now again when it proceeds, I will be the same and j will be incremented, j will be pointing to 3 now. Okay, so now print of ij, it means 1 and 3 will be printed. So after executing this inner loop, it has finished executing all the sequence, it goes for the outer loop. So outer loop, already it has executed for 1, now it goes for 2, I will be equal to 2. So when it comes inside, again it starts from first onwards. So j will be 1. So second time it is I is equal to 2, j will be 2, I will be equal to 2, j will be equal to 3. So when it finished executing all the numbers in the sequence, it goes to the outer loop. So I will be 3, j will be equal to 1, I will be 3, j will be equal to 2, and I will be 3, j will be equal to 3. So this will give you the output like this. Output will be like this. So since it is printing I and j, I am getting the values like this. So I think you all have understood this particular program. So using an inner loop inside an outer loop is called as your nested loop structure. Okay. There is one way of using this nested loop is that you can also use else statement with loop. So suppose Python, it's supposed to have the else statement with the loop structure. Else statement can also be used with while. So in many programming languages like C, C++, we will not be using this type of concept called else using with while. Usually we will use this else statement only with if. But here in Python, it allows you to use the else statement with while also. So how it works is while of expression colon, the statements you are going to give. If the condition becomes false, it comes to else part, it will execute the statement 3 and 4. Okay, this is how it will work. We will see one simple example for this else statement. So count will be equal to 0. While count is less than 5, colon, print count is less than 5, count will be equal to count plus 1, else print count is not less than 5. So initially count is 0. So it comes here. 0 is less than 5. Yes, it is true. So when it is true, it will print count. That means count value 0. it will print the value which you have given within double quotes. Is less than 5 will be printed on screen. Again, count is incremented. Now the count value will become 1. So initially it was 0, now it will become 1. So it goes again. Since it is a while loop, it will go for repeatedly executing. So 1 is less than 5. 1 is less than 5, it will print count. What is count? 1 is less than 5 will be printed. Now count value will be equal to, it will be incremented. Now it will become 2. So it, again it checked, 2 is less than 5. Yes, it is true. It will print 2 is less than 5. Okay, count will be equal to 3. So 3 is less than 5. Okay, 3 is less than 5. Again, 3 is less than 5 will be printed, and count will be equal to 4. So 4 is less than 5. 4 is less than 5 will be printed, and count will be equal to 5. So again, it will be checked. 5 is less than 5. It is false. So it comes to else part. It will print this line. So 5 is not less than 5 will be printed on screen. So you can use else statement with while loop also like this. Okay. So in this video, we have learned how to use a nested loop in your program. Nested loop is placing a loop structure inside outer loop structure, is called as a nested loop. And I have also taught you how to use else statement with loops. So this is the syntax for that. You can use else statement with while structure. In that case, you can use this type of concept in many of your programs. Okay, thank you all for watching.